use my 14-foot fast tracker tadpole. Start from the front here. This right here, jack was just replaced that last year. That's good. This is a 1 7/8 ball. Let's see. My rope is extra long for no reason. I'll probably end up just cutting that because there's no need to have that long of a rope. But a lot of times I'm launching by myself and I kind of hold on to it with the truck. An open floor plan. I don't really see a lot of John boats like this, but this is how this one is. Works great. You can walk around the whole thing, and it just very stable. I had 3 people in this over the weekend. I drove up to Maine, did a fishing trip, and it was very, very stable. It's very light as well, so the wind will definitely push it around, but very stable to walk around in. These fold up right here, both of them fold up, so when you're driving, you can just fold those up. Spare tire, which comes in handy because I popped my tire this year at the Housatonic and I had to replace it, so that is very, very handy. Trailer is in alright shape. I mean, I don't have any problems with it. That's it. The tires are good. The bearings I just did last year, so those are really good. I literally just took it to Maine over the weekend. That was a 5-hour trip, and I had no issues at all. I have a 30-pound thrust here. I know it's not the biggest motor, but it definitely pushes this just fine. Half the time, this is all I'm using. I don't always bring my motor with me, but this is mainly what I use. The battery is brand new. I don't think I'm going to be selling the battery with it because I just bought it and I'm going to need it for my next boat. Over here is my Johnson, 4-horsepower Johnson. I believe it's a 2000. That's the year. This thing is, I have water running right now so I can show you guys that it starts right up. This thing is a beast. It runs for days. It'll idle as long as you want it to. Great for trolling. Great getting to the spot to catch some fish. And I just had it serviced in April, I believe I had it, of this year I had it serviced. And then every year it usually gets serviced before I really start to get to heavy fishing. There's storage underneath, so you can store your tackle boxes and anchors and things like that. There's so many modifications that you can do with this boat, but I mean, I like the way it is, just like this. I put all my rods up here, and it's really a great boat. This is my fish finder. It just clamps on right here. That's the transducer right there, so it's portable, which is pretty neat. I may or may not be selling that with the boat. It all depends on what you guys offer me for it, because that was $250 and it's worth every dollar. So I'm not sure about that. Let's get this thing, the motor started. You can see how that runs. And actually, before I do that, I can show you this other stuff. This is some other stuff that I will give you with the boat. Some life jackets. Anchor there. There's another fish finder there you can have with it. I used to use that in my kayak. I used it in the boat a couple times as well. Works fine. The battery that's in there is brand new. Or you can just hook it up to the battery from the boat. But I like the other battery that's in there, so that way you can place the fish finder wherever you want and not worry about any wires at all. So let's start this thing up. You can see this run. Should start up within the first. gas tank with it. A little bit of gas in there that I just used over the weekend, so it's quite fresh. Any other questions, just feel free to ask. It's well worth what I'm asking for. I can't tell you how many fish I've caught out of this boat just this year alone. Well over 500 fish out of this boat this year alone. It's a very, very good boat. Only getting rid of it because I want a bigger boat and a smaller version of this. I want two different boats. This is kind of an in-between, and I don't really have any use for it anymore. But it'll definitely make use of it.